abroad, we are already seeing how DBAT is creating connections, which are building on and deepening those we have already established across the diocesan network of schools. As we think and pray into our diocesan vision and its aims, and particularly as we meet together today, let's consciously ensure, be intentional about how we as synod members and our PCCs widen our view to include our church schools, remembering that they're one of the most significant environments for engaging younger generations. Growing Leaders, another of our aims, has clear resonance with what the National Foundation for Educational Leadership is looking to achieve to provide. And it will be resourcing high quality development for many teaching staff associated with our churches, and perhaps a number outside of our churches. There'll be learning, there'll be theological reflection, practical things, which can be passed on and shared more widely in churches as well as in schools. We don't know whether children educated in a Church of England school are more likely to become practicing Christians than others, and that's not the aim of our engagement. But there are associations linking their overall well-being as adults with such a foundation. The nation, as well as the church, has been given a rich inheritance in our church schools, which we've often taken for granted. A challenge for us is that this inheritance requires renewed investment at a time when most dioceses are feeling quite stretched. Frankly, this sounds like a recipe for potential disaster, or the kind of combination which the Spirit of God prefers in order to do new things among his people. Shall we pray that it's the latter?